Good morning, it's Yvonne here from the Aussie Goddess to do your bonus reading for today. I'm sort of glad sometimes that I get to do a bonus reading because the what's cracking this morning was very, very deep, and I really feel that people needed to hear it. And sometimes I think it'd be nice just to have a very light love reading or something, because then I wouldn't have to deliver such serious messages. But I deliver what I'm given. I deliver where I'm led. So if that means that spirit wants to, you know, deliver a message to people because they're struggling at the moment, then that needs to be heard. So thank you so much for subscribing to my channel. We continue to grow. I'm loving the journey. Every day I get up and I enjoy doing these readings. There's so much pleasure in this for me. So thank you so much for subscribing. And if you're new, welcome on board, and thank you too. If you haven't subscribed yet, please think about joining us. However, if the readings don't resonate, that's okay too. There's always a reader out there that will resonate with your sort of reading or what you need. I know sometimes people say they don't need a love reading. Some people don't need the deep readings. Some people want to know about career, but the energies that come through in the cards are the ones that come through while I'm reading. So unfortunately, unless you're doing a personal reading, it's very hard to direct the reading. With a personal one, it's so much easier, especially if you have interaction with someone, because you can really get in amongst their energy and feel what their direction is. So, okay, let's have a look at the bonus read. We're still playing with the Julia Massaglia After Tarot. I notice a lot of readers are picking this one up again too, so it's quite a good deck to read from. Okay, we think we've shuffled enough. Okay, so Queen of Wands, now she came up in the daily read today. So I feel the same sort of energy here. It's almost like a lot of you are being represented in this card. Now, it could represent a Leo, Aries or Sagittarius. But the thing is with the Queen of Wands, her energy is so amazing because she's really comfortable with who she is, which the Queens are. They're still all, you know, they're not kings in the deck, so they don't have that power that the king does. They still have this much more vulnerable energy, and we love vulnerability. But she has a cat here which represents her intuition. So she's very much in tune with her intuition. She has sunflowers around her, which means that she's welcoming new life. But the thing that's beautiful is this wand here, because this talks about her moving forward with this passionate energy. So she's often, you know, very, you know, has beautiful sex appeal. She's very passionate. It's almost like that stuff is on the outside of her. So her energy is really, there's a word for it. But it's like palpable. You can feel the energy of her on the outside. And I feel like this is a lot of you at the moment. People feeling very, very much in touch with themselves. Okay, so the first card out is the card of the Sleep of the Dead. It's the meditation card. It's very spiritual. It talks about going inside of yourself and really taking time out. So something you may need a rest at the moment. This may be because you've been working too hard. It could be because you've been doing a lot of spiritual work. But whatever it is, you're being asked to, you know, take time out for yourself. For some of you, this may be, you know, arranging a holiday. It could be just about, you know, going back to meditation practices that perhaps you haven't been so conscious of. So we then have the Five of Swords here. So we have a lot of thinking energy coming in this morning. So the Five of Swords talks about, you know, having a battle with people. You've won the battle. You have. You've got their swords. You've got everything you want here. But the idea is that you're celebrating this alone. So it's always this thought of you've won something, but at the cost of what? He's holding up against the Four of Swords too. So maybe you've done something, you've had some sort of moment where you've realized, you know, you've managed to do something, but now you're totally exhausted by it. So some sort of outcome. We have the Three of Cups here. Now the Three of Cups talks about celebration, talks about, you know, weddings, births, you know, celebrating with friends and family. It's a great card for this. Some people do talk about it being a third party relationship, but I don't always feel that until I see the cards around it. At the moment, it feels like somebody's celebrating because they've achieved something here. But this achievement has come at great cost. And it could be that this achievement has been cutting something out of your life that no longer served you. But whatever it is, you're feeling very, very tired from this experience in need of rest. Okay, so we have another four here, the Four of Cups. So something you've been very, very dissatisfied with, and you've, look, you can see him throwing this fluid away, which represents love. So someone here has decided that they don't want to move forward with something. They're taking something out of their life that no longer serves them. So very clear here now that there are people out there who have removed something from their life that was no longer serving them. The thing is, whatever this was, it's drained you really badly and it's made you very dissatisfied here. So it's almost like you've been able to achieve something, but it's created this sort of like aftermath of, you know, feeling very empty, feeling very sad, feeling like you've had to leave something behind that maybe wasn't, you know, easy to leave behind as much as you knew you had to. But definitely this celebration here of being able to achieve that. The Hermit did come up in the What's Cracking reading. So again, people going deep inside to have a look at what's happening here. This overlays the Four of Swords. So I think that for a lot of you, this is about going back into that restful state or that meditative state to really look at what's happening. It sort of sits like that. So you can see that he's going back to have a look at what's inside now. So you could be grieving here. So for some of you, this can be about grieving. You could be grieving the loss of someone. It doesn't feel like dying grieving. It may be dying as in something has died inside you, because I can see people feeling very disenchanted, dissatisfied. So it's sort of like, you know, this is a time to celebrate, but it's really hard to do that when you're so tired and so over what's been going on. And this is definitely a time to take time out. Now the Wish card's coming up here, and the Wish card's coming right up in the middle. So I always think when that happens that there's a greater reason for this happening. There's always a good reason for things happening, even if they don't seem like they are at the time. No, not everybody agrees with that, so that's my opinion. But I feel like for everything that we do, everything we say, everything has a cause and effect, is what we're trying to get through here. Rightio. So we're looking at cause and effect. So what I'm thinking here is through something happening here, something greater is being brought in for you. So if you've had to walk away from a job or a person, something's had to die, you've had to cut something out, what the universe is saying is after a period of, you know, self-reflection, meditation and rest and being able to get away from this feeling of, you know, not being satisfied, you are going to bring something greater in for yourself. Yes, because you're finishing out a cycle. Rightio, this makes sense now. We're definitely finishing out some sort of cycle here. So for some of you, this can be something very, very tangible, physical. You're cutting something out that no longer satisfies you or serves you here. And it's okay, because you do have reason to celebrate. We've got the Nine of Cups here. But what the universe is saying is that there needs to be a finishing off of this cycle first. And in order to bring yourself round again, it requires you to take time out and rest. So in very practical terms, you could have decided to leave a job that was absolutely terrible and you're going on holidays, practical terms. But in terms of your spirituality, this means you are now going to bring in something much greater, because you have come to the realization that you need to leave things behind that no longer serve you. Oh, and we have a tower. Now, if you're doing what you need to be doing here, why does the universe need to bring you in a tower? I'm thinking, looking at this, I'm feeling that there was a lesson to be learned here, and although you've been through the process, you haven't grasped the lesson yet. because something has to be broken down in order for you to move forward after completing this cycle. And it feels to me like you've done what you've needed to. You're taking the rest out to recuperate from this, whatever it needs to be, and maybe starting to do meditation or something to get yourself back into a place where you can, where you're sort of balanced and equal and stable, because you've come through some sort of cycle here. But in order to move you forward to this Nine of Cups, the universe has to now bring in perhaps the idea that you need to do something very differently now going forward before you move forward. Okay, so it could be, for example, say you've come out of a job where you've been treated really badly and you've understood that, you've gone no more, you've cut it out, you've done your bit of celebration, you understand you don't want to have this sort of stuff anymore and you're ready to move in for a new job. And the universe wants to bring you in this new job, this new role, this fantastic thing will suit you now because you finished out this cycle where you're no longer tolerating bullying, bad behavior, all those sort of toxic environments. But see, what's happening here is you've got to realize the lesson before you move forward. So you may think it's just an awful workplace, but maybe something deeper is going on here. Maybe something within yourself that you haven't recognized yet that will be brought to you in this tower moment. Because the tower does talk about breaking down old structures. So it could be a way of thinking. And what they're saying is you can't go into this next opportunity unless you've learned what you need to learn. Yet, because there's some sort of offer coming in for you. So the universe is definitely moving you into a direction of having what you want here. Whether that's work, whether it's, you know, a relationship, could be anything here. I don't think it's about the situation so much as you going through this lesson. There's definitely learnings here. Beautiful, because it will bring in new abundance. So you are working your way towards something that will bring you abundance. Oh, I like it. Okay, quick recap. Something you've been through here. Something that's been quite tumultuous and you're ready to walk away from it, okay? You are ready to go. The thing is, what the universe is saying is you can have what you want. We have it right here in front of you. But in order to move forward now, you have to close out this cycle of whatever you've been doing incorrectly in the past, whatever you've been putting up with. So, for example, if you've been in jobs where it's been very toxic, you've been pushed around, not respected, and treated really poorly, it's all very well to walk to the next job. But if you don't learn the lesson that's here, you're just going to go back into the same job, the same relationship, the same situation. You're going to keep cycling if you don't get this right now. So what they're saying is you have to take this time out to meditate and have this rest, to go deep inside to understand what this lesson is, because the universe is going to bring you an answer here. But in order to have this answer, you have to do self-reflection. If you come out of this and don't take on this lesson, you'll just go straight back into another cycle. And that's sort of like the Wheel of Fortune stuff here, which we got in the bonus read, What's Cracking. The thing is, what I love is they're saying to you, by doing this, you'll be bringing in some abundance. You're bringing in something really beautiful that will be much more suited to who you are. It's a really, really nice reading, folks. Have a fantastic Tuesday.